So with the win, 78-49, Illinois advances again to the round of 62 or 32. They have now won 15 of their last 16 games. Illinois easily covers the 22.5, the over under. The under hits here at 143.5. All right, so taking a look at the bracket there, Illinois advances as most everybody thought they would. They will now play the winner of Loyola Chicago going up against Georgia Tech. By the way, that game at 4 Eastern on TBS. And between our experts, it's a toss-up between who advances out of those two. Shout out to Sister Jean in the house. Let's bring in college basketball writer Chip Patterson to talk about this. Illinois was dominant, Chip, and by all means, we thought they would be.
This was a spring game for Illinois. I mean, I'm glad they broke a good sweat out there. I'm glad they were able to run some of their offense. I mean, you look at the competition, and Illinois just knew that they were going to be bigger, they were going to be stronger, and they were going to have some advantages. And one thing that really stands out to me, if you want to look at the game as a whole in terms of what Illinois thought it needed to do to get past Drexel, there were 63 field goal attempts on the game for Illinois. Only 6 of them were three-pointers. And they only hit 2 of those. They didn't even try to get things going from behind the arc because they knew their best opportunity to get easy buckets was to get into the paint, whether it's Ayo Dosunmu driving to the basket, 0 three-point attempts, all of his points in the paint. Kofi Coburn getting it done down low, either off the glass or as we saw on that dish from Dosunmu on the dunk. I just think that Illinois knew that the key to this game was to get out, get in rhythm, shake off all the rust that you've had from the quarantining and from the onboarding process there in our bubble-like scenario in Indianapolis. And so for Illinois, check, check, check. Everything checks out great. You had your stars leading the way. The entire team picked up the pace. And for Drexel, not only were you going to be a little bit outmanned, but you shot 30% from the field. Like, most teams in this NCAA tournament are not going to beat Illinois, and most teams can't do it shooting 30% from the field. And Drexel, a team outside of the top 100 in the KenPom rankings, definitely cannot take down a team like Illinois shooting 30% from the field.
All right, Chip, let's look ahead to whomever they will be facing, either Loyola Chicago or Georgia Tech in this next game in the round of 32. Will either one of these teams provide them much of a challenge?
Loyola can, absolutely. They've got the number one most efficient defense in the entire country. And I think that the Ramblers really got misseeded because if you compare them to their AP poll rankings or if you compare them to their efficiency numbers, they should be much higher than number 8. And so that has placed number 1, you know, Georgia Tech at a little bit of a disadvantage. But should Loyola win, then that is a big disadvantage for Illinois. And I think Illinois's got the toughest path to the Elite 8, where you could be staring down Loyola in the second round, Cade Cunningham and Oklahoma State in the Sweet 16, where Houston on the other side of the bracket, I think, has a much more manageable path when you look at West Virginia, the 3, and San Diego State, the 6. So it's like, if Illinois can get to the Elite 8, Amanda, I know the Fighting Illini, your pick to win it all. They're a Final Four team for me, too. But I'm more nervous about the second round and the Sweet 16 than I am about what might happen after that.
It was a nice warm-up for them. So we're just going to say that. It was a nice warm-up right for them. All right, Chip Patterson, thanks for hopping on with us to talk about that. By the way, you can hear more. Everything college basketball. We are in the tournament. We waited almost 2 years for this, guys. Download and subscribe to the Eye on College Basketball podcast.
Want a sports network that delivers everything that matters about the game? The highlights, the picks, the instant analysis. No yelling, no fake debates, no politics. Hit the subscribe button and never miss a moment.